Greetings everyone, tis I, Demonic Grimshin. Gotta speak a little bit louder because as you can probably hear, the heater is on. I thought my parents turned that on. Anyhow, I can't remember the last time I actually did a video response to a channel with a higher subscriber count than mine, like Clownfish TV, but it was last night. I was minding my own business, just trying to see what other video I could watch or have playing in the background while writing my torturous experiment novel in the description about that. And I saw Clownfish TV upload a video entitled Chun-Li's Not Mortal Kombat, with the thumbnail, of course, Chun-Li having a confused expression on her face. This a still from Street Fighter 2, the movie. And I was like, there's no way someone actually wrote an article asking about that. There's no freaking way. There's no way. This is Poe's Law. At least someone correct me in the comment section on that. You know, Poe's Law, something so absurd you can't tell whether it's parody or legit, because it's that absurd. That's what this is. A site called Jezebel, which is apparently like a branch associated with like, the Onion and in IO9. So you'd think, yeah, it would be. But the fact that they even made a correction on that very same article, we just found out that Chun-Li is not a Mortal Kombat character. Our mistake, the fact that they even put that in the article lets you know, yeah, this was not meant to be a joke. Like, Mortal Kombat and Street Fighter 2 are a little over 20 years old. So, how anyone in this day and age, outside of the gaming sphere at least, does not know this fact astounds me. Heck, you could have just Googled Chun-Li. Just type her name in Google, and you would have clearly gotten that she's from Street Fighter 2. She debuted in Street Fighter 2 back in 1993. I should know that. Childhood. She's the first lady of fighting games, for goodness sake. Which, leads me on to at least something that was mentioned in the article that let me know that these people were a whole special brand of it. Because it's like, They ask the question, where's Chun-Li in her spinning bird kick? I'm sorry? That's the move you went with? That's the move you went with mentioning that she has? Not her fireball? Or her lightning kick? A move that I'm pretty sure I'm not the only Street Fighter player who in every iteration of Street Fighter, or pretty much every crossover game that Chun-Li is featured in, then, like, the first move I try to figure out how to do with each game she's in is her lightning kick. That's, like, the first move I test is, like, okay, let's see if I can do this. Which button initiates her lightning kick? Like, hey, that... That's like one move that, like, even casuals spam the crap out of that move, I think. Pretty sure. Speaking as a casual, yeah, pretty sure I'm not the only one who spams the crap out of that move. And you went with her spinning bird kick. Okay. Alright. Sure. But it also feels like you can tell, too, by, like, the fact that this even happened, that they were just desperate for clicks. They were just desperate for clicks. They couldn't just write an article expressing their excitement for the Mortal Kombat movie. No. That would have gotten a lot of clicks. No. They had to do the virtue signaling crap. Because let's not mince words here. As dumb as that stuff is, it does get attention. And this did get attention. I mean, the fact that even a person like myself, who just earned a new subscriber, by the way, hi, welcome to my channel, good sir or ma'am, which would put me at, I think, 193 at this point, 194. Even I'm making a video about this. Just because it's like, what? But the point I'm trying to make is, you know they were desperate because they probably already understood how diverse the cast was from Mortal Kombat. I mean, in terms of black people representation, you got Jax and his daughter. In terms of female representation, let's list some of the favorites. Sonya Blade, Melina, Katana, Zadira, Jade, Shiva, Cassie Cage, which was a recent addition, who was the daughter of Sonya Blade and Johnny Cage, which, yeah, I kind of figured that was inevitable, but, let's see, yeah, you got Frost of the Lin Kuei clan, the same clan that Sub-Zero's in, you got several more, but off the top of my head, those are the ones I can think of. So yeah, the Mortal Kombat franchise is not starred for female representation, nor is it starred for Asian representation. Because I don't know if this has been changed, but from what I understand, Sub-Zero, both of them, Bi-Han and his little brother, were originally from China. Scorpion, Hanzo, is from Japan. And then you got Liu Kang and Kung Lao, who are both Asians. And if you want to go that far, Bo Rai Cho. So yeah, it's a pretty ethnically diverse game. And of course you got the various creatures. There's from various realms, like Outworld and Netherrealm. So again, yeah, it's pretty ethnically, genderly, and in terms of species, very diverse. So I can understand why these people were trying to reach for something the virtue signal about. And it was like a train wreck. A train wreck that a lot of people were obviously watching, like, wow. I didn't think you could create a blunder that bad. Jeez. I'm ugly. But yeah, just Oh, this was just wow. Pardon my cynical, angry bitterness for a brief second. Like, this is also one of those moments that, as a cynical and angry person, then I sometimes tend to think there's no way I was right for 20 years for people to be this massive species of idiots. Yet here this is, just to prove me right, and it's like, why? Just why? 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 Just why? But yeah, I should be able to make my announcement, or announcement, my reaction to the Mortal Kombat trailer soon, because honestly, I didn't expect a third Mortal Kombat movie, one, in my lifetime, two, to come out this year, and three, for it to even look as good as it does. So yeah, then look forward to that later. Yeah, this is Demonte Grimson signing out. I'll see you all in the next video. Have a nice day. Also, support my Patreon, which, as I often like to remind, is optional. But yeah, this ain't going up on my Patreon, just so y'all know. Oh!